Praise the Lord. Glory be to God Almighty that God has ordained for you to be in this particular edition of the Love Revolution broadcast. I believe that God is going to bless you mightily, strongly, and effectively to the glory of God. In Jesus' name, amen. This edition of the Love Revolution broadcast, for the next few episodes, are going to center on a strategic ambushment 2015 that was held at the Desert Pastures of the Fountain Gate Chapel in the month of January to start the year 2015. Every year in January at the Desert Pastures and other parts of the world, I hold some meetings called Strategic Ambushment to prepare the body of Christ and prepare believers for the year that God has put before them. And the term ambushment or strategic ambushment is very important for us to notice. I will define an ambushment or an ambush. In the Bible, in the authorized version of the Bible, we are told that there was an ambushment that God laid against his enemies. Modern language, we will normally say an ambush. But let me just go with the term ambushment. That an ambushment or an ambush is a military tactic where combatants employ the element of surprise and also the element of concealment to be able to attack their enemy or an opposing force. So there is an element of concealment where you hide yourself in order to spring a surprise. And at the beginning of every year, what the body of Christ and believers must do is to be able to conceal themselves in fasting and prayer, seeking the face of the Lord, and be able to launch an attack on the enemy by surprise. So it is a warfare of wisdom, a warfare of supernatural force. You must understand that we are in a warfare. The Bible said, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh, but that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Strategic Ambushment 2015, Bogatanga, and the theme was Signs and Wonders, which is the theme of EAM for the year 2015. Signs and Wonders was our theme. And in that Strategic Ambushment program, in 5 meetings, I addressed 5 questions. Number 1, why criest thou unto me? God asked Moses and the people of Israel, why are you crying when I have put weapons of war in your hands? Unleash them instead of crying unto me like babies. Why criest thou unto me? And I asked another question, which was very important. And that question was, can these bones live? Can these bones live? God showed Ezekiel dried bones and said, Ezekiel, can these bones live? And he said, thou knowest. I asked another question, who touched me? Where Jesus said, virtue has left me because somebody has touched me. I asked another question, is any sick among you? Is anybody sick among you? Is anybody sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil. The prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he has committed any sins, they shall be forgiven him. And I ask another question, have you received the Holy Ghost? These are 5 important, powerful questions that were asked at Strategic Ambushment 2015. You are going to be coming across them one after the other, and your life will be seriously blessed. I pray that as you watch, your life will be blessed. God bless you, and I will see you soon. Is any sick among you? James the apostle, in his letter, asked this great question. Is any afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let them sing hymns or psalms. Is any sick among you? Let them call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over them,
anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up, and if he has committed any sins, they shall be forgiven him. Is any sick among you? 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 And I know that when I say, is any sick among you, you are likely to say you are not sick. Because you don't have a cancer. You are not crippled. You don't look blind. You don't look deaf. So you may say, I'm not sick. But that word sick, from the original language, the Greek, does not mean somebody who is medically sick. It means a wide range of issues. Anybody with any form of disability, emotional, mental, spiritually, is sick. Anybody who is weak is sick. Anybody who has disability is sick. So when he says, is any sick among you? What he's saying is any crippled? Is any impotent? Is any weak? Has anybody got disability? Is anybody lacking in anything? Is any financially sick? Is any intellectually sick? Is any family-wise sick? Is any sick in any way? Do you have any deficiency, deformity? Do you have anything that makes you different from others? Do you have any abnormality? Do you have a condition that makes you feel inferior to somebody? Do you have a situation that you wish could be improved? And then one that has a situation which you believe could have been improved, you have a sickness. Is any sick among you? Is anybody unwell? Is any sick? Is any regretting? Is anybody in pain? Is anybody in trials? Does anybody feel tormented? Does anybody feel oppressed? Does anybody feel suppressed? Does anybody feel afflicted? Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil. Anointing him with oil. Is any sick? It didn't say, let him call for scientists. Let him call for fetish priests. Is any sick among you? It didn't say, let him call his mother. Let him call his father. Is any sick among you? Let him call the elders of the church. The elders of the church are the presbytery of the church. They are the shepherds or the poimen of the church. These are the watchers over the souls of men. These are the people that are specialists in praying for the souls of men. I tell people all the time, doesn't matter what you think about pastors, whether you like them or not, we are the poimen. We are the shepherds. We are the presbytery. You don't like us, but that is our domain of calling. The engineer is the engineer. The policeman is the policeman. The doctor is the doctor. The lawyer is the lawyer. Let me tell you this, point blank, eyeball to eyeball, engage without intentions of disengaging from your eyes, because I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. If the doctor is the doctor, and the engineer is the engineer, and the lawyer is the lawyer, I tell you, the pastor is the pastor. That is our domain. Nobody takes care of emotional sickness like us. Nobody takes care of mental problem like us. When it comes to spiritual realm, we are the experts. Is any sick among you? Don't let him call apprentice. Let him call the elders. Is any sick among you? Let him call the elders of the church. Why are you sick and you are not calling? Mantal mokeferi kataha. Labrani mozigi yatata. Eye! I was sick. I was in my house. 3 months. Nobody visited me. But did you call? Did you call? Did you call? Let him call. Let him call. Let him call. call, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, he shall be saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous, they run to it and you are safe. I declare to somebody right now, in this building, any sickness you have is curable. There is no incurable disease in the house of God. There is no difficulty that is unsurmountable in the house of God. Receive your healing tonight in the name of Jesus. Is any sick? Let him call. For the elders of the church, is any sick among you? It didn't say call for gossips. It didn't say call for people who will come and sympathize with you. There is no room for sympathizers in the kingdom. There is a room for elders. Elders are not sympathizers. Elders are solution dispensers. Is any sick among you? Let him call for sickness experts. When you have a police case, you look for police. You have a car problem, you look for fitter. If you are sick, look for a pastor. Look for an elder. Incidentally, the elders are senior pastors. Peter said, I am an elder. John the apostle said, I am John the elder. Look for people in a certain area of jurisdiction. Look for people with a certain unction, mantle upon their life. Look for some people that God has separated for a certain purpose. Hey, yeah. These hands are not a carpenter's hands. They are anointed for the impartation of the anointing, for the healing of the sick. In my name, they shall lay their hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover. And tonight, as my hand comes upon your body, and the oil comes upon your body, I see healing, I see miracles, I see signs, and I see wonders. Receive it in advance, in the name of Jesus. Come on, scream like your voice is yours. Praise. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders. Why are you sick when there are elders? Doctors don't look for sick people. How many doctors in the Bogatanga General Hospital have come to your house before? When you are sick, you look for them. Nobody visited me. If they don't visit you, visit them. What I'm saying is, kings and presidents, they are looking for God. Stop sitting in your house and compelling God to come to your house. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders. If you call, they may come to your house. If you call, they may say, come to the church. If you call, they may say, let's meet under a tree. If you call, they may say, let's meet in the church building. Is any sick among you? Let him call. And watch this. It is God who said call. If the people did not have the solution, God will not say call them. Any anointing you believe in will work for you. Don't sit in this building. Look down on the grace of God and think your healing can come from somewhere else. Because the one that gave grace to another person who can heal you is the same one who gave the grace. Is any sick among you? Let him call. He didn't say let him wish, let him desire, let him complain, let him murmur, let him cry. Is any sick, let him call. I want somebody to do this. I'm calling for the elders. I'm calling for solution dispensers. I'm calling for the people that have the answer to my problem in their hands. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let me give you an announcement. There is oil in the house. Number two, there are elders in the house. And that is why tonight your healing is guaranteed. There is no way this preacher, who is a Bible walker, when I say I'm a Bible walker, it means I walk in the Bible. I don't know my way around Bogatanga, but I know my way about in the Bible. One day I heard a certain verse, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. No man can do these things except God be with him. Tonight, if God has determined to heal you, I knock an amen on God's intentions. Somebody shout an amen and your healing will be yours. Scream like your voice is yours. Press. Is any sick? Let him call. There is no way this Bible walker can quote James chapter 5 verse 14 and 15 and leave Jeremiah 8 22 to go scot-free. If I free Jeremiah 8 verse 22 from the impact of my spiritual digestive juices, I will be excusing this scripture to your disadvantage. But let us pull it up and see if healing will not be released in your body. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is the health of the daughter of my people not recovered? What it means is this. How can you be sick with this oil? Is there no balm in Gilead? Can I tell you this? There's oil in this house. Can I tell you this? There is a physician in the house. There are pastors in the house. Men of God in the house. Anointed men of God in the house. There are elders in the house. If only you can believe, you will see signs and wonders. If you are willing and you obey, you will eat the good of the land. Come on, scream like your voice is here. Anointing you believe in that will work for you. If there is an anointing, no matter how dire it is, if you don't believe in it, it won't work. But if you believe it, even if it's a child who carries the anointing, it will work. Tonight, there is efficacious anointing in the building. Elected, validated, authenticated men of God are in the house. That is why, based on authority, audacity, unction, I speak the word of God upon your life. Sickness, leave their body. Weakness, leave their mind. Inability, leave their life. In the name of Jesus, come on, hit an amen on that one. Is there no balm in Gilead? Gilead. And actually, when he said Gilead, this place where the balm was not actually in Gilead. It was a few miles away from Gilead. And the balm was the resin of balsam. It first came into Israel by the queen of Sheba, who brought the balm or the resin of balsam from a place called Arabia Felix. Arabia Felix is called Happy Arabia, and it is found in the southern part of the Arabian Peninsula, specifically Yemen. So the Balm of Gilead came from Yemen, which is now the domain of terrorists. Sometimes, when the people of God don't receive good things from good people, the people turn around to become evil. When there's a good place and good people don't use it, the place becomes evil. But the Arabian Peninsula, southern part, Happy Arabia, Arabia Felix. That word Felix means fortunate, blessed. It means happy. And in that place, they had the resin of balsam, and it had healing properties. And some people settled in Gilead who were experts in applying that medication. So Jeremiah is asking, why are these people sick? When there are healers, physicians in Gilead, and there's a healing balm in Gilead, do you have an excuse not to be saved with all these preachers in Ghana? Do you have an excuse not to be born again with all the radio messages, television messages? You have no excuse. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders. And he said, if there's balm in Gilead and there are physicians in Gilead, why then is the health of the daughter of my people not recovered? The reason is they have not believed. But whosoever believes, salvation, healing, deliverance will come to him. Tonight, in the next few minutes, I'll be holding some oil here. I will be standing here. I will anoint all of you, including the noisemakers who have now taken the end of the pole to shoot a corner. I'll be laying hands on all of you. And by virtue the anointing, every yoke will break tonight. By virtue of the anointing, every principality will be disarmed. Receive your healing.
I trust that your life has been blessed. Why are you not saved? Why are you not healed? Why are you not delivered? The Bible said, is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is the health of the daughters of my people not recovered or restored? After watching what you have seen, I believe that it is important for you to give your life to Jesus and to be healed and be delivered. If you want to believe in the Lord Jesus and give your life to him, can you bow down your head and pray this prayer after me? Say after me, Lord Jesus, I confess that I'm a sinner. You died for me. You were buried. You rose from the dead. You are alive forevermore. Come into my heart. Be my personal Lord and Savior. I give you my spirit. I give you my soul. I give you my body. Dear Lord Jesus, take my life and use me to your glory and your honor. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for making me your child. Because of my faith in your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you died for me. You rose from the dead. You are my soon coming King. And I give you my life. I love you with all my heart. Thank you, my Father. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, thank you for the lives of my friends who are born again right now. I commit them into your hands. I ask in Jesus' name your healing power upon them. I pray that your power of deliverance will be upon them. I ask in the name of Jesus that they will experience the love of God and the grace of God, that you will cause them to be separated, holy and righteous, sanctified and set apart for God. Let your mighty name be glorified in their lives. To you be glory and honor. In Jesus' most excellent name, we thank you, our Father. Amen. God mightily bless you. I trust that you will never be the same again. Remember, I love you in a most special way. May God continue to increase you from grace to grace. The love revolution continues unabated. Love somebody, even your enemies. Pray for your enemies and do good to the people that seek to hurt you most. But above all, be very wise as you escape all the traps of the enemy. The Lord deliver, keep you, sanctify you wholly for his appearing. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Presence of the Lord is here. Presence of the Lord is here. Presence of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere.